Please, everybody, stand up.
Okay, what is the greatest thing about Rails? So maybe it's programmer happiness. This is what Rails is optimized for. Or maybe it's a beautiful code that Rails lets you to write. Or maybe it's a testing framework that is built in Rails. Or maybe it's a community, the best developers community in the world. Or maybe it's a high quality code the community usually produces. For me, it's the fact that the Rails is an opinionated framework. So it saves the time of not making the same decisions all over and over again, like naming tables or name controllers if you follow the rest, or where to put source files, or how to test the code. And we don't have a queue abstraction layer in Rails 4. And actually many other things that allows us to save time. So I looked back and tried to understand what kind of decisions I had to make over and over again. And let's start with obvious ones, static pages, like privacy policy, terms of services about us, and all these things that are actually not static at all. I mean, sometimes customer wants us to change them, but I don't want to change them. I mean, I think that people who really understand what's written there should be managing these changes. So what we miss here to save again my time as a developer is some kind of basic CMS, not a full-featured monster, but something that could solve this for me. So the problem is we have too many choices now, and every time I start a new project, I have to make research what's the best way to do this now. So we have a high voltage for Rails engine for static files. We have refinery CMS, a really huge one to manage content. We have a browser CMS, another CMS for Rails, as well as comfortable Mexican sofa. Well, this one was picked because of a funny name, and another about 20 projects worth mentioning. So some folks will say it shouldn't be a part of a framework. I'd say, why? I mean, we have an ERB, it's a default language, it's a default template language in Rails. Well, I personally hate it, but anyway, I use Haml. But anyway, this choice has already been made for us, and people who love HTML can use ERB and enjoy this template language. For example, we had internationalization as a plugin for quite a while until it became a part of a framework. And it keeps text in separate YAML files. So it could be a good start. So we probably can manage or keep these legal documents in text style or markdown and ask lawyers to work directly with them. I believe they can manage. So what I at least miss here is some kind of basic CMS. Another thing is CORS. It's a cross-regional resource sharing. So let me show how it works. We can have a client on example.com that makes AJAX requests to another domain, to a server that runs on another domain. So most of modern browsers supports it, IE8 supports it as well. So what are our options to do? We can play by ourselves with headers like access control our region, or we can use a recourse middleware. This one actually is a good candidate to become a part of a framework. So next is JSON serialization. We have two options here. The first says JSON is a business logic and it should be somewhere in the model. So to put it in the model, we have to override as JSON method, and we can probably override it in something like this. So we can pass some kind of parameter in our controller to JSON. For example, we will pass short true, and then as JSON will eventually receive it and try to understand if we need a short version of JSON, it will use constant as JSON short. If we need a default one, we will use a default one. So the short version contains ID and name attributes, and the default one also can contain methods like voiceover URL. And we also can use associations here, and the structure of census association will be defined in a constant SJSON on the sense class itself. So it's pretty simple, but anyway, there are another approach which says, well, JSON is not a business model, it's a representation, and it should be in a view. And we have JBuilder from Rails, or JSON Builder. The idea is more or less the same. We don't have to do anything in controller, just say that it responds to JSON, and then define the structure of this JSON in a view. So this is the short version of meaning, which has only ID and name attributes. Anyway, I'm not sure I want to spend my time thinking about JSON, because I have much more interesting things to think of, like user authentication. Okay, we have OmniAuth, and we have device, and they actually become a standard de facto. Why wouldn't at least their ideas become a part of Rails? So, I mean, we have more applications that have some kind of authentication than applications that use Q. Okay, so another thing to be, as short as possible, another thing to talk about is real-time web. It's hard to imagine an application that doesn't need to update its content in real time. So you can check out a push technologies overview. Vitaly was speaking on a DEF CON about 2 months ago. Here we have the slides and the script. So I'll take the idea of a dump server, no business logic, no persistent, and try to explain what's going on here. So we have a client that sends some content, creates or updates the content, sends a request to Rails. Then Rails notifies push server, and then push server sends these updates to different clients. We have a few hosted solutions that allows us to do that, like Pusher, PubNub, Hidna, and others. Most of them use the channels and messages concept. So clients subscribe to channel, and message published to a channel will be delivered to all its subscribers. Let's take a look on the code of PubNub. So we have PubNub new, some authentication, blah, blah, PubNub.publish message to a channel. And somewhere on the client, we can have PubNub subscribe channel with callback function, which will eventually receive this message. So it's not far from looking like that. Config push PubNub, and then Rails push publish channel and JSON. So in this case, we will publishing some comment to a channel that is that belongs to a post. So everybody who is watching this, who is looking on this post right now, will receive all the comments. And then somewhere on the client side, window and push function, channel name and message. So the same way we already have the same level of abstraction implemented in Rails Q. Okay, the last thing is actually pagination, and we've got all this will paginate with Caminari, the choice we have to make every time, and we also have infinite scroll, which is very popular and quite fancy to do in all the recent projects. So it's, I feel like we need some kind of abstraction for it to plug in different implementation of paginations. So all these and probably some other features can become a part of the framework, because they actually should save a lot of time to developers to spend on this, or this, or this. Thank you very much. Questions?
With the push framework, have you made a suggestion to integrate it into Rails?
Can we go, please?
As a messaging queue that will be released in Rails 4 with the push notifications, have you made a suggestion to integrate it into Rails?
Well, every one of them has libraries. I mean, there are gems for Pusher, gems for PubNub, and basically you just have to send a notification in your application, like, you know, like you're sending emails. You can send on after create or after update when something is changed, or you can just call some notification, send them controller. Really depends on how you build it. And we're actually thinking about making some abstraction layer that will allow to just send message and plug different implementations like PubNub, Pusher, or Hidna behind with some default implementation of something.